aerobic application for the adults after mass here and for children as usual. The Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. At that time Jesus said to his disciples, "There shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations by reason of the confusion of the roaring of the sea and of the waves, men withering away from fear and expectation of what shall come upon the whole world. For the powers of heaven shall be moved, and then they shall see the Son of Man coming in the cloud with great power and majesty. But when these things begin to come to pass, look up and lift up your heads, because your redemption is at hand." And he spoke to them a similitude: "See the fig tree and all the trees, and they now shoot forth their fruit. You know that summer is nigh. So you shall, when you shall see these things come to pass, know that the kingdom of God is at hand. Amen, I say to you, this generation shall not pass away till all things be fulfilled. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall not pass away." Know that it is now time for us to rise from sleep. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. These words of St. Paul in today's epistle very suitably opens the season of Advent, which is a period of preparation, like a little Lenten season to prepare for the feast of Christmas. In this season of Advent, we are invited to prepare ourselves for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. The coming of our Lord Jesus Christ are threefold. Yes, we must prepare for the coming of Jesus in three ways. First, for the historic coming of Jesus incarnate in Bethlehem. Second, the sacramental coming of Jesus Christ in the Blessed Eucharist. Third, the coming of Jesus at the end of times, the eschatological coming of the Lord at the end of times. In this first Sunday of Advent, the Holy Gospel invites us to meditate upon the second coming, the eschatological coming of the Son of Man, coming on the clouds of heaven to judge the mankind. Let us therefore contemplate how our Blessed Mother has been sent from heaven with her apocalyptic plans to prepare mankind for the last coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. What is the plan or the role of the Blessed Virgin Mary in the latter times? God wishes to send Mary, his mother, as the last of the prophets, with her plan of mercy, plan of might, and her plan of grace, in order to bring back poor sinners to the Catholic Church by mercy, in order to fight against the enemies by might, and in order to animate and sustain his faithful children by grace, thus to conquer the devil and establish in the kingdom of peace and love throughout the world. That is the role of the Blessed Virgin Mary at this time. Hence our preparation for the coming of the Lord consists in understanding the plan of Mary, and chiefly in conforming ourselves with this plan of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Let us try to understand what exactly is the plan of Mary to prepare us for the coming of the Lord. First, the plan of mercy. God knew what would happen to the world and to the Catholic Church when Russia would spread the errors of atheistic communism throughout the world. Hence, God sent his mother to warn mankind and to call them for conversion through prayer, sacrifice, and reparation. This is the plan of mercy designed by God through Our Lady. So Our Lady said in Fatima, if people do what I ask, many souls will be saved and there will be peace. But if people do not stop offending God by their sinful life, He is going to punish the world by means of war, hunger, and persecution. Russia will spread its errors throughout the world. The good will be martyred, and various nations will be annihilated. Yes, my dear brethren, we must examine now this prophetic intervention of Our Lady, how it has been understood and accepted by us. We speak many things about Fatima's message, the apparitions and miracles and prophecies of Our Lady. But we hear and speak and stop with that. There is nowhere in the world there is a congregation or a community bent on doing what Our Lady asked at Fatima. Convert yourself from sin. Pray more. Pray more sacrifices for the conversion of sinners. Accept from the hand of God all the sufferings He sends to you and offer them for the conversion of sinners and in reparation the sins committed against Our Lady of Fatima. Yes, my dear brethren, we must plan to enact the plan of Our Lady. We must have a plan. Our Lady gave a plan. Everyday plan is to pray the rosary. And praying the rosary is not simply praying the rosary, but it is living the rosary. Living the mysteries of the rosary. In our family life, we reflect and meditate on the family life of the Holy Family. How they lived. How was their life? It was a model of simplicity and poverty. simplicity and poverty must be seeked for. But whatever we do every day, think about, 24 hours we think about how to increase the pleasures of the body and the world. Just reflect. We do not comply ourselves with what our lady asked us. If we really reflect and meditate on the joyful mysteries, our family will become exactly like that of the Holy Family. To live like them in simplicity and poverty and gain graces by that. Just see our Lord's life from the birth to the death. He was poor. Always poor and simple. And Our Lady was an example for that. And Saint Joseph, as the head of the family, was always suffering by doing hard work, the hardest work and the sincerest work of a man in the world is carpentry. In carpentry we cannot bluff people, we cannot deceive them. You must do exactly how a table looks like, how a chair looks like, how the people want us to do. You have to do exactly, otherwise you will not be paid. That's the most sincere work which Saint Joseph has chosen as his trade. Hard work, simple life. Every day when he comes home, after getting some salary of that day, there will be people waiting at the door of St. Joseph's house to receive the alms meant for them. One part of the three in the salary will be given to the poor every day. They will come and get it and go. Another part of the three is put for the temple of Jerusalem, for the maintenance of it. And the third part of the salary is only made use of, for the living of the Holy Family, every day. And many days, he will come back empty-handed. And that will be accepted very happily by Our Lady and Our Lord. They liked poverty and simplicity. That is the example we must learn from the joyful mysteries and live the rosary in family. It's a model for family life, the meditation of the joyful mysteries. Secondly, her plan of might. When Louis de Montfort says, the Most High with His Holy Mother has to form for Himself great saints who will be chosen to match themselves against the enemies of God. True Devotion, number 48. These enemies, namely the idolaters, heretics, schismatics, atheists, pagans and Jews, were so far found only outside the Catholic Church. But now in many forms, they are seen inside the Catholic Church, having the same ideals, evil ideals of the idolaters, schismatics and atheists, heretics. And they are considered inside the Church no more enemies, but teachers of heresies. They are teaching heresies and we have to hear it. See the enmity of Satan. The infiltration of these enemies into the church has been realized so successfully that the shepherds of the flock have accepted these principles of modernistic French Revolution, namely equality in the name of collegiality, liberty in the name of liberation theology, and fraternity in the name of ecumenism. Hence, the apocalyptic intervention of Our Lady with her plan of might must now take place in order to rout the enemies, rout the red dragon, which has drawn by its poisonous tail the majority of the stars of the Catholic Church, the great people, cardinals, archbishops, and bishops, drawn down to the earth, to the earthly thoughts. Now we must examine how this plan of might, the battle cry of Our Lady, has been understood and accepted by her own children in the Catholic Church. Yes, we speak many things about the errors of modernism in the Church, the Vatican Council too. We speak about it, but we do not think about it. If we think so, we must be the people to produce those saints whom Our Lady expects. Produce saints. Be saints first, then only you can produce others as saints. We need saintly priests in the world now. Priests like St. John the Baptist, priests like St. John Bosco, Da Miki Animas Cetera Tolle, give me only souls, take away all other things, give me only souls, salvation of souls. Priests must be there. This burning zeal for the salvation of souls. They must multiply very soon to save the Catholic Church and fight against the errors of modernism with their own knowledge about divine truths, theology, philosophy, well taught, as it was done before. That's why we have started seminary here. We must have more seminarians, more holy seminarians, more priests, more holy priests. We are praying for it. The parents who are blessed with children must think of bringing forth children. I was very happy to see on the All Saints Feast here those parents who had children, some many, they were careful to bring their children, exactly like one of the saints. And that gives an idea to these small children now itself, that they have to become like that saint. In our days, poor parents and the elder brothers and sisters were reading saints' life in our homes every evening. And chiefly the name, the saint of the name which the children have, they must know what the name of their saint means. how that saint lived and how he and she should live and become saints. Yes, practice them now itself. When they receive Holy Communion, they must know how to confess, and as a fruit of the grace of confession, how to avoid sin. Not to repeat the same sin in all the confessions. They must be taught from the young age to avoid sin. And at a time when they come to the level of sanctity, they must go to confession to confess no sin. That is the meaning of children's becoming saints. Third plan of grace. God wishes that His Holy Mother should be at present more known, more loved, and more honored than she had ever been. Because Mary is the one who with the grace and light of the Holy Ghost shall fashion us and make us worthy instruments and apostles for the purpose of extending the kingdom of Jesus Christ over that of the enemies. Saint Louis de Montfort says, number 55. Yes. The plan of mercy. Our Lady says at Fatima, exactly as Saint Louis de Montfort foretold 300 years ago, Jesus wishes to make use of you to make me better known and better loved. Every one of us must be instruments in the hands of Jesus to make Mary more known, and more loved, more honored. He wishes to establish in the world devotion to my Immaculate Heart for that. To show that we love Our Lady more, we honor her more, by practicing, really and sincerely practicing the devotion taught by Our Lady at Fatima. Devotion to her Immaculate Heart. It should be practiced, and for that it should be established throughout the world by the authority of the Church. So these apostles of the latter times are to be fashioned now from among us in the Immaculate Heart of Mary. Hence the total consecration to the Immaculate Heart of Mary and the real living of this consecration is necessary now more than ever. Total consecration to the Blessed Virgin. This mystical invention of Our Lady with the plan of grace must play a vital part in each and every one of us so that we may become those true apostles of Our Lady whom Our Lady is desperately seeking for as an effective solution to the present day crisis. Only the apostles of Our Lady, as the apostles of our Lord, when our Lord created the apostles, now Our Lady wants to create apostles of Our Lady at the end of times for the effective solution of the present day crisis. So we are worried about the present day crisis in many times, in many ways, but we are not worried about how to solve this problem. Solution is given by Our Lady, by ourselves becoming real apostles of Our Lady. The power of Mary will especially shine forth in the latter times when Satan will lay his snares against her slaves, her children, whom she will raise up to make war against him. In union with Mary, they shall crush the head of devil and cause Jesus Christ to triumph. Again says St. Louis de Montfort, number 54. Yes, my dear brethren, we see face to face the warfare between Mary and the devil. Both are gathering soldiers to fight with. I will put enmities between thee and her, and she shall crush thy head. Genesis. And in the end, my immaculate court will triumph, said our Lord. In the end, surely, her immaculate court will triumph. By the help of those apostles who gather around her. So that must begin now, here, in our families. Engage yourselves seriously in creating the apostles of Our Lady in order to practice and propagate the devotion taught by Our Lady, chiefly the first Saturday devotion. It is spoken about, but not practiced. First Saturday devotion is not practiced enough. It's not taught enough. It is a solemn celebration. Not simply, yes, I went to Mass on first Saturday. I made confession. I said rosary. I finished. No. It should be a solemn celebration. The time must be adopted for that. Say for Saturday morning Mass or 11 o'clock or in the evening. Spend some time before the Blessed Sacrament exposed to pray the prayers taught by Our Lady. The two prayers, my God and Most Holy Trinity. These are prayers meant to be said 1,000 times in front of the Blessed Sacrament exposed and prostrated on the ground. These are the prayers most effective to fight against and rout the enemies of Our Lady. And the Fatima children, the three children, until they died, millions of times, prostrating on the ground, were devoutly saying these prayers. And whenever they could chance to go in front of the Blessed Sacrament, they did it. And every first Saturday must be a day of adoration. Maybe the whole day adoration. People must come and go, remain in front of the Blessed Sacrament, and say these prayers, say the Most Holy Rosary, meditating. And then the other prayers composed by the Catholic Church, which are said in Fatima, where Our Lady appeared, every first Saturday. Thousands and lakhs of people come there, day and night remain there, and recite all these prayers. Prayer of the Rosary, Prayer of the Cross, Meditations. All these are meant to be celebrated in a grand manner. So we have started in a small scale from this Saturday. After Mass in the morning, we had a short celebration. A little statue brought from there in procession and placed here. And the introductory prayer. And the most important thing is to be with Our Lady meditating. At least the mystery of the Rosary or what Our Lady taught about making reparation to the five kinds of offenses committed against her. All these must be meditated in the presence of Our Lady, together with her, in order to console her. Whenever we find some of our family members very sad, maybe because of some accident or some death, what do? We go there and sit by them, so that we have come there to console them. With that feeling, we must be with Our Lady on first Saturdays, meditating and praying and giving consolation to Our Lady. And through which, through the Immaculate Heart of Mary, you console the heart of Jesus also. Every first Saturday, we expose the Blessed Sacrament, and there we adore the Sacred Heart of Jesus together with the Immaculate Heart of Mary, as asked by Our Lady at Fatima. Most important. So please find time, according to your convenience, the time can be changed to celebrate this devotion more solemnly in this place, so that people may throng to come and fulfill the desires of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Therefore, my dear brother, real preparation for the total consecration to the Immaculate Heart is the most perfect and suitable preparation for the feast of Christmas. Let us therefore rise from the sleep of spiritual tepidity and slothfulness and engage ourselves in the apocalyptic battle cry of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Yeah.